Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In this video, we'll learn about installation and configuration of Citrix XenApp 6.5 on Windows Server 2008 R2. I'm assuming that you have basic understanding of application virtualization, and you are aware of the advantages of application virtualization. If you are not sure about application virtualization, then I'll quickly run through the concepts of application virtualization. What is application virtualization? Application virtualization means that an application is not installed in the traditional sense, although it is still executed as if it's there. The application behaves at runtime like it is directly interfacing with the original operating system and all the resources managed by it. In layman's term, application virtualization means that you have not installed application on your device like laptop, desktop or mobile, but it can be accessed from the server. I'll quote an example to make it more clear. Let's assume that you are at client's location and client shared some files like VSD files for which you don't have software deployed on your laptop, that is MS Visio software. In this scenario, we are assuming that you don't have MS Visio dump or software with you. Therefore, you cannot install MS Visio on your laptop. Now, in this situation, you have three options. First option, you ask your customer to help you with MS Visio software so that you can deploy it on your laptop. But it sounds weird. You cannot ask your customer for the software, can you? No, right? Second option, you can purchase the software and install it on your laptop. Will you do that? No, right? Maybe you'll do it, but what if you need about 3 or 4 softwares? That would be very costly, right? And not a viable option, right? Third option, you can request your IT admin to install MS Visio on Citrix server, which is hosted in your data center. And then you can access MS Visio via Citrix XenApp. Third option, in which we are accessing application from server, is actually application virtualization. In this scenario, application is deployed on server, which is hosted in data center, but application can be seamlessly accessed from anywhere and almost on any device like laptop, desktop, thin client, mobile, your tablet, etc. Hope with this, you must have got an idea about Citrix XenApp application virtualization. Before we start with the installation and configuration of Citrix XenApp 6.5, let's build an environment. Let's make a list of servers that we need to provision. We need to have a domain controller for authentication and centralized management. If you are not sure about the steps of installing and configuring domain controller, then please click on the link shared on the screen. It will help you with the steps of installing and configuring domain controller. We'll name domain controller as DC01. Domain will be created when we install a domain controller. Domain is actually a logical security boundary. What is domain and extensive information about domain is not part of this video. That's the reason we are not covering it. We'll name the domain as ProHut.net. We need a Citrix management server, that is Citrix XenApp server, on which we'll install Citrix XenApp 6.5. We'll name it CTX01. Please use either uppercase or lowercase while defining computer name, as Citrix license is case sensitive. For this video, we'll take uppercase. We need to have a database server for Citrix, that is data store server. It contains all the static information, example, your farm configuration, published application configuration, server configuration, etc. For this lab, we'll use SQL 2005. You can even use SQL 2008 or SQL 2012. We'll name this box as DB01. We need web interface server. It's a kind of website which we need to create to access applications. End users will access this website to access applications. We'll name it WI01. We need license server on which we'll install Citrix licenses. We'll name it LIC01. To load balance our Citrix environment, we need one more Citrix server. We'll name second Citrix server as CTX02. In next video, we'll see the practical of installation and configuration of Citrix XenApp 6.5 on Windows Server 2008 R2. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye, keep smiling, and have fun. We'll be right back.